Welcome back to Paper Pen Biology. In this monsoon season, rapid growth of fungi along with other microbes is common. I made a workout video of Ascobolus, a coprophilus fungus, previously, where I performed dissection to demonstrate its vegetative structure. Please watch this video first for better understanding. Today we are going to explore its wonderful reproduction pattern. So let's learn. Reproduction takes place both asexually and sexually. In Ascobolus carbonareus, asexual reproduction takes place by the formation of conidia on the mycelium. In Ascobolus catagenus, formation of some specialized sclerotium-like asexual reproductive structures called papulospores, which consists of one or two large central storage cells surrounded by a covering of hypha, which later form blister-like outgrowths. This pore never gives rise to ascocarps, but on germination produces somatic hypha. In Ascobolus starcorarius, large number of oidia are formed in chains from both the mycelium derived from an ascospores. Each oidium on germination produces new hypha. Sexual reproduction takes place by gametangial contact method. The ultimate product of sexual reproduction is an apothecium. Ascobolus catagenus is a monoecious form, that is, capable of bearing both antheridia and ascogonia. These are the sex organs, like male sex organ and female sex organ. But it is a self-sterile form, that is, self-incompatible, because sexual reproduction does not take place in a single thallus. This species shows two complementary strains, A and B. Each, when grown alone, produces asexual spores, but neither is able to form sexual branches bearing sex organs. When these two strains, A and B, meet each other, male organs, that is antheridia, rise on a younger, and the female organs, which is ascogonia, on the older hyphae of both strains. Normal fertilization takes place only when sex organs of two complementary strains, those are A and B, come in contact with each other. This condition indicates that Ascobolus catagenus is a biologically heterothallic and cross-fertile form. The young sexual branches after the differentiation are multinucleate. Shortly they divide, forming short club-shaped, one or two-celled and multinucleate structure. When two complementary mycelia, that is A and B strained, are intermingled, the sexual branches may be scattered singly or very frequently associate in pairs or in groups of 3 to 4. The grouped or paired branches elongate, one of which elongates more than the other. The more elongated one is the female branch, while comparatively shorter one is the male branch. Both the branches become septate very soon. Generally, the female, that is ascogonial branch, becomes more septate and is differentiated into a terminal and septate trichogyne, a globose unicellular eugonium and a multicellular stalk. Ascogonium is a multinucleate. The male, that is antheridial branch, remains erect and becomes a cylindrical or clavate body, that is antheridium having granular cytoplasm, many nuclei and a stalk composed of 2 to 4 cells. Union between antheridium of strain A and ascogonium of strain B or vice versa takes place. At first, trichogyne of the ascogonium elongates rapidly and grows out and coils twice or thrice around the antheridium. The antheridium and a trichogyne of the ascogonium fuse with which other at or near the apices. When both the sex organs are fully developed, continuity, that is a passage, is established between the antheridium and the tip cell of the trichogyne by dissolution of walls at the point of contact of the antheridium and the trichogyne. The male nuclei begin to leave the antheridium and gradually move from cell to cell through the perforated septa of the trichogyne and finally pair with female nuclei in the gonium. After pairing of male and female nuclei, the ascogenous hyphae begin to bud out from the gonium. The paired nuclei enter into the ascogenous hyphae, which later on become septate. Septa formation in each ascogenous hypha takes place in such a way that each cell contains two nuclei, that is a paired nucleus. Ascus formation takes place from the subterminal binucleate cells, also called penultimate or ascus mother cell, of each ascogenous hypha by the hook, that is Crozier formation method. The two nuclei undergo fusion within ascus mother cell, that is penultimate cell, forming a diploid nucleus. The diploid nucleus divides thrice. Of this, the first division being reductional, as a result, 8 haploid nuclei are formed, which when surrounded by cytoplasm constitute ascospores. While the formation of asci and ascospores takes place, some vegetative hypha grow upwardly surrounding the sex organs and form a compact fleshy cup-shaped fruiting body, also known as apothecium. Fruiting bodies, that is apothecia, are up to 5 mm in diameter, sessile or substipitate, grow superficially or partially embedded within the substratum. They are fleshy and cup or saucer shaped, generally greenish in color. The upper surface is concave, plane or convex and form hymenium. The hypothecium lying below the hymenium is pseudoparenchymatous. Hymenium bears septate paraphysis and asci parallelly. In Ascobulus, asci are projected well beyond the level of the hymenium of the apothecium. Asci are cylindrical and clavate, phototrophic. Ascospores are multiserratedly arranged within the ascus. Paraphyses are slender and generally adhering together. Mature ascospores are dark colored. They are elliptical or subglobose, either smooth-walled or becoming sculptured. The ascospores are liberated through the apex of asci in large numbers under moist conditions. These spores are scattered by wind over considerable distances. On falling upon a suitable substratum, each germinates by putting forth a germ tube and develops into a new hypha. Here we can summarize the life cycle of Ascobulus catigenus. This is all about this class. I'll be back soon with new video. This is the book which I read for making this video. Please read books first. Share your thoughts, opinions in comment box. Thank you for your patience.